So my name is Simon Manchipp, and I'm the co-founder and executive creative director of SomeOne. And SomeOne is a silly name for a serious business in London, but we're working all over the world on launching and relaunching brands. They can be small ones, big ones, all sorts of ones, really.
So we've been working a lot with Cancer Research UK, and I've recently developed a sub-brand for their kids and teens section, which uses a graphic language of doodles. Because obviously we want to reflect the kind of youthful side of this part of the company.
I think that specifically what's been really fascinating to have the Cintiq in the house is that there's been two really interesting things happening. So one is that this kind of need for refinement, and one is the kind of desire for origination. So actually they said that Concorde was the last beautiful aeroplane because it was designed by hand, because that wing is actually the perfect arc of a wrist. Whereas now you've got these incredible dreamliners and things that are actually pretty ugly, but they're obviously designed by a computer so that they can be very efficient, etc. So actually when it comes to refinement, the hand is obviously a very sophisticated tool, and we're working on some work at the moment that actually is almost heraldic in its basis. And so we've been doing it all by hand, just getting these perfectly refined lines, and it has been truly amazing for that.
The Cintiq has been absolutely amazing in the development of this brand identity, because it's just, I mean, firstly, the great thing is you can kind of use it like a sketchbook. It's really free, and to get your ideas down and quickly visualize things is it's just super easy, and it speeds up the process.
Getting that illustrative style through instantly is kind of been quite a nice, natural, fluid way of working with the Cintiq.
So I was mainly working with an illustrator. The best thing was I could kind of just sketch away, you know, start developing ideas for these doodles. But then I had the flexibility of changing the different brushes and, you know, altering the different stroke weights and things afterwards, which was really useful. And it also meant that we could create a suite of doodles that all aligned and they all looked cohesive.
So I suppose ergonomically in usage it's been great, because we've always kind of used tablets and Wacoms, and there is a certain kind of restriction with size, but suddenly we've got this in front of us, and yeah, it's great. You get the full arm movement, you get full kind of range of use, if you like.
In the perfect world, you can draw in a sketchbook and then go Control Alt Delete, or, you know, undo, and actually with the Cintiq you can do that. It's pretty awesome. You know, you can draw with one hand and then you can just go undo, you know, with your left hand. And
the biggest kind of most fun we've had with it and experimentation is using it in Illustrator, because the kind of the pressure sensitivity and the kind of natural fluidity of it has lent itself really nicely to creating the kind of stuff that we've wanted to create.
We've been using it on live projects to enable us to better connect with those audiences. And it's been amazing, genuinely amazing. We don't want to give it back.